Multileader plant labels are very easy to place, move, and align. They're able to pick up the plant data, and you can verify and fix labels to be completely accurate. But another great feature is that you're not limited to the default styles we provide. Here are the steps and tips to customizing a plant multileader label style. Importantly, there are two types of outcomes for your multileader style: block callout or MText callout. You need to decide which one you're going to create, and they're both great. A label with only one MText or one attribute, with or without text underlining, becomes a multileader with MText, using the concept multileader style. A label with any other type of line work or more than one attribute requires a block attached to the multileader instead. It gets created with a multileader style that corresponds to the block name and scale. MText labels are easier to customize and are typically concise, simple labels. A block style label is a bit harder to customize but gives a lot more flexibility and creativity for the style, allowing more lines, shapes, and text sizes. Let's run through making a block style first, and then an MText style after to see the difference. First, open Planting Preferences and click on the Plant Label Preview. Make sure you're on the MLeaders tab. Pick a style that's closest to your end goal. In this example, we'll use this one. Click OK and go back to the Planting Preferences. Now, click on the Open Label Files button. This opens the LAFX Plant MLabel block that lives in your LandFX/blocks/graphics/callouts folder. It'll be an imperial or metric version depending on the units of your drawing when you click the Open Label Files button. You can move, copy, or draw lines as needed now. Keep track of the origin point. This is where the leader of the multileader will eventually attach to. Keeping it near the center is best. You can only use one block with a multileader, and it can't flip or use dynamic controls. So you should organize your information roughly centered around the origin. The leader will stop at a vertical line landing along the x-axis from the origin point. That's easy for a box style label. The leader will stop at the edge of the box. But for a cross style label, there's no lines to stop the leader. You need to add non-plot vertical ticks where you want the MLeader to attach to your block. You can add more attribute information a few ways. The best way to make a totally new attribute is to copy or edit an old attribute. Keep the text style as plant callout. The existing text size is also important for any text that you need to match the plant callout size set in your general preferences. Double-click the attribute to open the attribute editor. Change the tag to match the attribute you need. Follow our Attribute Definitions for Plant Labels documentation page for what's available to choose from. Set an attribute to all caps with caret symbols on either side of it. You can string as many attributes as you want together in a single line. Use an underscore for a space or a dash for a dash. Space dash space can shortcut with an equal symbol. You can also put quantity inside brackets if you want. To add a dynamic background mask to an attribute, make sure the attribute is set to multi-line in properties. Click the triple dots, drop down the arrow in the text formatting toolbar, and click background mask. There will be no actual default text, and that's okay. Check Use Background Mask and then Use Drawing Background Color. Click OK to everything. In some types of labels, you need a mask to fill a frame, like a circle or square. Use a solid hatch set to a white plotting color in your plot style. We recommend the LK Anno Label screen layer set to color 133, which screens to zero and plots white in our default CTB plot style. Save this block back into the callouts folder with a new number so you'll always be able to distinguish your custom label from our defaults. After saving, do a zoom extents and use the MSlide command, saving an SLD file with the same name to the same folder. This will become your preview slide. We're done making a block style. Before setting it and using it, let's first review making an MText style label instead. Back to the label style selection in Planting Preferences, start with an MText style first. Now open up that label file. First, you'll notice that this is one MText object or one attribute object with a text underline instead of multiple attributes or separate polylines. This is how it needs to stay. You can make this as many lines as you need and string the attributes together in the same way as explained earlier in the video. You can highlight and set an underline to the top line only. This will result in this text landing above the leader line and the underline becoming the leader line. Otherwise, the top line will center vertically with the leader line. Avoid any MText formatting other than underlining. By default, the system will set a background mask to an MText leader. You don't have to do anything here for it. However, keep in mind that an MText multi-leader with a mask will apply a box background mask to the entire MText. If your style has two lines and one line is really long, that will leave a lot of empty whited out space in the shorter line, and maybe a block style with two attribute objects is a better choice for this style. Again, keep the origin generally centered in the label instead of on one side or the other. That's it! Much simpler for a plain label. Save your changes as a new label number and MSlide it. Let's set it and use it. Open your plant preferences and callout styles again. Set the style to your new custom number. You can see both of our example styles showing up here. Click OK to everything. Test this in a completely new drawing with no defined blocks or MLeader styles to make sure your customizations work. Testing your block this way is extremely important. Most questions to us about customized labels not working is from testing in a drawing where the block or MLeader style is already defined differently. Here's that difference in label types again. If you need to update an existing label drawing, you will need to first clear the existing MLeader style and block definitions and then relabel. Do this by deleting all the labels and purging all those definitions out. This is why it's important to tweak the label customization to your office standard before labeling a full construction plan. That's all the ins and outs of customizing a multi-leader label that you need to know. Have fun making the perfect label of your dreams.